Yes, yesterday we did Faraday's experiment, and there were two postulates also, two laws also, Faraday's experiment, right? Who will tell me the first postulate of Faraday? First law given by Faraday. Yes. Raise hand if you know. Yes, yesterday we did in detail Faraday's experiment. Who will tell me the statement of first law and also the other name for first law, what it is called? Yes, no one. First law is also called EMI, electromagnetic induction. What is that? Who will tell me? So as you can see in front of you, there is a simulator, and Faraday had taken a coil, a galvanometer and a magnet. So what happened? What is the first law? Yes, who will tell me? Not even a single child. Two laws were there, na? Tell me the first one. Yes, students. Yes, Gursimar. Yes, Gursimar. Unmute, beta, unmute yourself.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Yes. What is Faraday's first law?
Whenever there is a relative motion between coil and magnet, an induced current is produced in it. This is called electromagnetic induction.
Yes, very, very good. This is also called Faraday's law, and this is also called electromagnetic induction. So whenever there is a relative motion between a coil and a magnet, an induced current is produced in it. So see, I'm going to operate this simulator. Okay, so let us produce a relative motion between this is coil and this is magnet. So see, when I'll move the magnet, bulb glows. When I take it away, again the bulb glows. We can have a voltmeter also to see the direction of deflection. Okay, when I bring it closer, this is the deflection. When I bring it away, the deflection is in the opposite direction. So these are the observations of Faraday. And we can also draw field lines. Okay, to make the concept of magnetic flux clear. So see, when the magnet is far away, the lines are hardly passing through the coil. Okay, when the lines are, magnet is away, then the, now I'm moving it closer, you can see the number of magnetic lines passing through the coil has increased. That means magnetic flux of coil has increased. And because of that, induced voltage, induced EMF, induced current is produced and bulb starts glowing. And bulb is glowing in both the cases, right? Galvanometer is showing deflection in both the cases. Why? Because in first case, when we bring the magnet closer, magnetic flux is increasing. In the second case, magnetic flux is decreasing. Change may be of any type. It may increase or decrease, but it should change. So whenever there is a change, we find induced current. A very practical example is when we switch on a geyser, sometimes we see a spark across the gap of the plug, gap of the switch. Okay, so why do we see that spark? This is the production of induced EMF or voltage, and this happens only at the time of switch on or off. When we switch on or when we switch off, only then this happens. Otherwise, it doesn't happen. Okay, because after some time, induced current becomes zero because magnetic flux is no more changing. Change takes place only at the time of switch on or switch off. Like when I'll keep the magnet inside the coil, see, induced EMF has become zero. Induced current has become zero and bulb is not glowing, though the magnet is inside the coil. because the flux is not changing, it has become constant. We have kept the magnet inside the coil. So you should understand this thing. Whenever there is a change in magnetic flux linked with the coil, only then induced current or induced EMF will be produced. If I reverse the poles, okay, if I reverse the poles, south here and north here. Okay, otherwise earlier north was here. So when I bring it, deflection, direction of deflection you can see is reversed. And now again reversed. So this is a good simulator. You can do various experiments, various imaginations with the help of this simulator. Whatever you want, you can do like he did in the actual experiment. Okay, on the basis of what we read yesterday, I'm going to give you a question. You open a separate tab on Mentimeter, right? Separate tab on your phone and type www.menti.com, menti.com. And I'll give you a code. You will type that code. A question will appear in front of you. Yes, type the code, I'll tell you. Wait a minute. Yes. Open www.menti.com and type the code 7224-2282. 7224-2282. Let us see how you answer. The direction of force when current is passed through a coil placed in a magnetic field is given by which rule you have to tell. Options are Maxwell's right hand thumb rule, Fleming's right hand rule, Snow rule, Fleming's left hand rule. Yes, two students have responded. I again repeat the code 7224-2282. All of you try it. Very good exercise this is. You people are so smart technically, so you can easily do this. Open menti.com and use the code 7224-2282. Yes, very smart. 8 students have responded. Hurry up, all of you. 9. So from your poll, we will come to know which is the right answer. Current is passed through a coil placed in a magnetic field. Which rule gives the direction of force? So 13 students have responded. Hurry up, out of 36. 13 are able to do, all will be able to do. Hurry up, try it. Yes. I repeat the code. 7224-2282. 15 students have done this. Others also do it. Yes, 16. I'll wait for 2 more minutes. Then I'll stop it. 17. Yes, very good. Come on. 18. Yes. Okay. So I won't share it anymore. 3 students are saying Fleming's right hand rule and 15 students are saying Fleming's left hand. So obviously the answer is D part, Fleming's left hand rule. Because in the question it is asked what is the direction of magnetic Lorentz force, and we know that is given by Fleming's left hand rule. This was indirectly the principle of motor, that when current is passed through a coil placed in a magnetic field, what is the direction of force? Okay, so two forces are generated along the two arms, and these forces produce a torque that rotates the coil, right? That was about the working of electric motor. And you know, in explaining electric motor, we used which law? Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, so let's come back to this. Fleming's right hand rule I had stated. Now diagram is to be drawn. So again, stretch first three fingers of your right hand in such a way that they are mutually perpendicular. If forefinger gives the direction of magnetic field, thumb gives the direction of motion, then central finger, middle finger will give the direction of induced current. Okay? अब ऐसे ही आपने किया हुआ है ना, ऐसे ही आपने कॉपी पे हैंड रखी है लाइक दिस, तो आपका डायग्राम बन जाएगा. सो आई एम गोइंग टू कीप इट हियर और आई विल ड्रॉ द डायग्राम इन द सेम वे लाइक वी डिड फॉर फ्लेमिंग्स लेफ्ट हैंड रूल. लाइक दिस. ओके, सो दिस इज थंब, दिस इज थंब, this is forefinger, this is middle finger, and along thumb motion of the conductor, magnetic field along the forefinger, and along the middle finger it's induced current. So this is how you can draw the diagram. You can draw the diagram like this. So Fleming's right hand rule gives the direction of induced current. Okay, clear? Diagram you have drawn. Okay, now one interpretation. Suppose this is coil. Let's talk about in which direction the deflection or current will be produced in the galvanometer. When the north of magnet is brought closer, north of magnet is brought closer, induced current will be produced in the coil. And there is a law called Lenz's law. It says that induced current is always produced in such a direction that it opposes the cause producing it. Apne hi cause ko oppose karti. Induced EMF is so selfish in nature, you can say, that it opposes the cause producing it. ठीक है? तो जब हम north को लेके आ रहे हैं coil के पास, तो here north pole will be induced. यहाँ पे जो pole induce होगा, जो effect हमें लगेगा, north will be induced such that it will oppose the cause producing it. It was produced because magnet was coming closer and it will hinder the coming closer, the approach of magnet itself. उसी को ही ये oppose कर देगा. Magnet के approach की वजह से current produce हो रहा था, ये उसी को oppose करेगा by inducing the same pole. So north pole will be induced here. North, always remember, north pole means anti-clockwise direction. You know, magnetism and electromagnetism, when current and magnetism are related. So when north pole is induced here, that means through this coil current will be flowing in the anti-clockwise direction. So deflection in the galvanometer will be towards right. This is the first case. And what happens now? North is produced. If we want to bring the magnet closer, north will repel it. Okay, we have to do work against that repulsion now. Okay, अभी सिर्फ magnet को move करने के लिए work नहीं करना था. Yesterday I told you that some form of energy is converted into electrical energy. So I am explaining what energy is converted into electrical energy. हमें work किस के लिए करना पड़ेगा? Against that repulsion we have to do work. Okay, so to continue the magnet moving in the same direction, we have to do work against that repulsion, this work, this mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. Is that clear? Yes, Jasleen.
मैम जो आपने लेंस लॉ और ऊपर ये डायग्राम बनाया जो नॉर्थ साउथ वाला राइट हैंड रूल के साथ जो डायग्राम बनाया है वो वाला समझ नहीं आया, लेंस लॉ वाला.
क्या पॉइंट समझ नहीं आया बोलो?
मैम वो शुरू से ही नहीं समझ आया जो लेंस लॉ आपने करवाया.
लेंस लॉ बस ये कह रहा है कि जो इंड्यूस करंट प्रोड्यूस हुआ है इज ऑलवेज अपोजिंग इन नेचर. लाइक आई टोल्ड यू कि अगर हम नॉर्थ लेके आएंगे तो नॉर्थ ही प्रोड्यूस हो जाएगा. अभी मुझे दूसरा केस बताने दो फिर पता लग जाएगा आपको. ठीक है, अब सेकंड केस क्या है? सेकंड केस इज दैट वी आर नाउ मूविंग द नॉर्थ अवे फ्रॉम द कॉइल. अब हम नॉर्थ को दूर लेके जा रहे हैं. ठीक है, नाउ वी आर टेकिंग द मैग्नेट अवे. नाउ साउथ पोल विल बी इंड्यूस्ड हियर टू अट्रैक्ट इट. इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड, इंड्यूस्ड करंट विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द कॉइल बिकॉज मैग्नेट इज मूविंग, देयर इज चेंज इन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स. ओके, बट इट विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन सच अ डायरेक्शन इट अपोजेस द कॉज प्रोड्यूसिंग इट. दिस इज कॉल्ड लेंज़स लॉ. Like North Pole is going away, South will be induced here. That will attract the North Pole of magnet and it will try to oppose going away of the magnet due to which it itself was produced. Understand this point, right? पहले magnet pass आ रहा था तो same pole induce हो गया उसको repel करने के लिए कि ये और close ना आए. Second case में North was going away तो ऑपोजिट पोल इंड्यूस हो गया उसको अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए कि ये गोइंग अवे इसकी प्रिवेंट हो सके. सो इट विल अपोज द कॉज प्रोड्यूसिंग इट. दिस इज कॉल्ड लेंज़स लॉ. राइट द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ लेंज़स लॉ. लेंज़स लॉ स्टेट्स दैट, लेंज़स लॉ स्टेट्स दैट इंड्यूस करंट इज ऑलवेज प्रोड्यूस्ड, इंड्यूस्ड करंट इज ऑलवेज प्रोड्यूस्ड in such a direction, induced current is always produced in such a direction that it opposes the cause producing it, such that it opposes the cause producing it. Okay, so south means clockwise. So when south pole is generated here, that would mean current will flow in the clockwise direction or towards left. Current will be flowing in the clockwise direction or it will flow towards left now. Is that okay? Is that clear now? I hope that is clear. So attraction will be taking place now. So if we want to continue the magnet moving away from the coil, we have to do work against that attraction. Again, in this case, we have to work, do the work, but against attraction now. So that work, that mechanical energy will be converted into electrical energy. Is that okay? So I repeat both the cases. In the first case, we are bringing north pole of magnet closer to the coil. North will be induced. It will repel further motion of magnet towards it. We have to do work against repulsion. This mechanical work, this mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. So this whole experiment is in accordance with conservation of energy. Because like I told you, ki aise lagta hai ki ye koi miracle ho raha hai, apne aap electricity produce ho rahi hai. But through this Lenz's law and through this experiment, we are showing that it is only a conversion of energy from one form into the other. Mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. In the second case, see, we are taking away the magnet. Due to that, due to change, induced current will be produced in the coil. This is called electromagnetic induction. But in this case, south will be induced here. So this south pole will attract the north pole of the magnet, which is going away. So attraction is taking place here. It is opposing its own cause. We were taking away the magnet. It is attracting the magnet. So if we want to continue the magnet moving away from the coil, we have to do work. अगेन दिस वर्क, दिस मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. अब बताओ किसको ये क्लियर नहीं हुआ, दोनों केसेस किसको क्लियर नहीं हुए, यू कैन रेज हैंड. सो इन बोथ द केसेस यू कैन सी करंट्स आर फ्लोइंग इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शंस. ओके, करंट्स आर फ्लोइंग इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शंस इन बोथ द केसेस. इज दैट ओके? यस. डाउट टू एनीवन नाउ? यू कैन आस्क. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट फिनोमिना आफ्टर दिस इज म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन. दिस इज EMI, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. और एक आप एग्जाम्पल लिख लीजिए. नेम अ डिवाइस वर्किंग ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ EMI. नेम अ डिवाइस वर्किंग ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. कैन यू नेम दैट डिवाइस? यस. नेम अ डिवाइस वर्किंग ऑन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन EMI. हु विल आंसर? विच डिवाइस इज दैट? Yes, raise your hand. Jasleen, batao. Yes.
Ma'am, pata nahi. I don't know.
Humne kiya nahi. Kal aapko maine bataya tha na. Shuru hi maine wahan se kiya tha. Aaj bhi bola maine. Yes, Krishan. You should listen carefully. Yes, Krishan. Yes, unmute yourself. Krishan, unmute yourself. I'm asking you to unmute. Okay, Harshit, aap batao.
Ma'am, electric motor.
मोटर का तो प्रिंसिपल कुछ और ही था. व्हेन करंट इज पास थ्रू अ कॉइल प्लेस्ड इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड टॉर्क एक्ट्स ऑन इट दैट रोटेट्स द कॉइल. कृष्ण, आप म्यूट ही अनम्यूट नहीं हो पा रहे. यू नो द आंसर आई थिंक, बट यू आर नॉट एबल टू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. हर्षित का एक सेकंड में हो गया. यस, एनीबडी, एनीवन एल्स? अमृत, आप बताओ.
जनरेटर.
जनरेटर, यस, दैट इज डायनमो और जनरेटर. आज भी मैंने कहा कि जैसे जनरेटर में भी ऐसे ही होता है कि वी थिंक दैट इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज जनरेटेड. नो, इट इज कन्वर्टेड फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म इनटू द अदर. देयर द शाफ्ट ऑफ जनरेटर इज रोटेटेड, मैकेनिकल वर्क इज डन, दैट मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. ओके, सो इसका आंसर होगा इलेक्ट्रिकल जनरेटर और डायनमो. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड डायनमो. Okay, generator is also called dynamo. चलिए अब next है हमारा phenomena mutual induction. अभी हमने किया EMI, electromagnetic induction. This is mutual induction. It's about two coils. इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन में वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली वन कॉइल. म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन इज अबाउट टू कॉइल्स. ओके, सपोज वी आर हैविंग एन आयरन नेल और आयरन रॉड, व्हाटएवर, वी वाइंड टू इंसुलेटेड कॉपर वायर्स, टू कॉइल्स ओवर इट. दिस इज वन, दिस इज टू. कॉइल वन, कॉइल टू. And this is iron rod. Now we connect cell and a key across the first coil, and we connect a galvanometer across the second coil. This is our setup. Now what we will do? Yes. What we'll do here, now we will press this key करंट विल स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग थ्रू कॉइल वन. करंट विल स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग थ्रू कॉइल वन. सो देयर विल बी चेंज इन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स थ्रू कॉइल वन. बट गैल्वेनोमीटर ऑफ सेकेंड कॉइल विल शो सम डिफ्लेक्शन, क्योंकि वो कॉमन बेस पे हैं दोनों जो कॉइल हैं, को एक्सियली वाउंड हैं. तो चेंज करंट में एक में हो रहा है बट इंड्यूस्ड करंट दूसरे में प्रोड्यूस होगा. दैट विल ट्राई टू अपोज द चेंज इन करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द फर्स्ट कॉइल. दिस इज कॉल्ड म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन. ठीक है, अगेन देर इज चेंज इन फ्लक्स, बट वो पहले कॉइल में चेंज हो रहा है और इंड्यूस करंट दूसरे कॉइल में चेंज प्रोड्यूस हो रहा है. दिस इज कॉल्ड म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन. ठीक है, आई विल गिव यू वन एग्जांपल आल्सो. टेस्ला कॉइल इज एन एग्जांपल. लिखिए पहले व्हाट इज म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन. व्हेन करंट थ्रू वन कॉइल, व्हेन करंट थ्रू वन कॉइल चेंजेस, या आप ऐसे भी बोल सकते हो व्हेन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स ऑफ वन कॉइल चेंजेस, इंड्यूस करंट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द नेबरिंग कॉइल. व्हेन करंट थ्रू वन कॉइल चेंजेस और व्हेन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स थ्रू वन कॉइल चेंजेस कॉमा एंड इंड्यूस करंट इट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड एंड इंड्यूस करंट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द नेबरिंग कॉइल. And induced current is produced in the neighboring coil. Okay, this is called mutual induction. This is called mutual induction. And a device working on this principle is called a transformer. That you all must have seen in the streets. Transformer. Okay, so it's a device that works on the principle of mutual induction. Okay, it works on the principle of mutual induction. All right. In the same video, I want to show you this small activity. It will just take a while. Just a minute.
College part is pointing towards the number. Now see, I bring an electron pole and the cell, like north pole and coil here, and a fluorescent tube. The two coils, EMI is also called mutual induction. So see, I have a mini Tesla coil here and a fluorescent tube. Mini Tesla coil produces high alternating potential. And when I bring the voltage, this tube in contact with the Tesla coil, then it starts blowing because of mutual induction. Plasma formation takes place inside the tube and electrons, they collide with the gas atoms. So because of ionization, the fluorescent tube starts glowing without any power supply. When a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences torque that rotates it. This is the principle of an electric motor, and the experiment is called snake head experiment.